There are over 3,000 emotions out there, but the normal person knows around 12. Hello, and welcome to the Spark series. This is your host, Asmâa Methqal, and I hope that you are having an amazing day, week. And so today I wanted to show you one simple tool that I started using in the past few months that really helped me label emotions. And as we know, like in terms of emotional intelligence, the more we are able to clearly label the emotions that we are feeling, we are able to better respond to the events around us, right? So we're not just reacting, but we are able to respond because we were able to go a little bit deeper in levels in order for us to clearly identify what is exactly the emotion I am feeling right now. And there are over 3,000 emotions out there, but the normal person knows around 12, right? Like that's how it is, and that's totally okay. But we know that in the more we are able to clearly express how we are feeling in the exact moment, we are able to better witness that emotion, heal it, connect to it, identify the triggers behind it, and hopefully heal it, let it go when we can, right? And so the tool I wanted to talk about is called the mood meter. And what this amazing tool does is it identifies around 100 emotions that are identified in four quadrant, 25 each, and it really helps us better identify exactly or label exactly the emotion we are feeling. And we can do that by answering around two questions. And so here is the process. First of all, really find a quiet place or really where you can be able to just relax and there is no distractions. And when you are there, the next thing that you do is that you close your eyes and you really take three deep breaths, right? And your feet grounded on the floor. And once you are able to do that, then start to scan your whole body and see where do you feel a certain emotion, like where in your body? Is it in your chest? Is it in your close to your heart? Is it in your tummy? Like is it in your back, in your feet? Like really scan and identify where that emotion is. And once you do, then the first question you ask yourself is, if I could rate this feeling, this emotion from 1 to 10 in terms of pleasantness, how would I rate it? And what I mean about pleasantness means how pleasant this emotion could feel. Like we know that there are positive emotions and negative emotions. And when we talk about negative emotions, like we have this contraction, right? And then when we talk about positive emotion, we feel expansive, we feel open. And so really identifying how you would rate that feeling, that emotion from 1 to 10 in terms of pleasantness, right? And knowing that 10 is super pleasant, super amazing, right? And the second question, once you identified that, is what is the, how would I rate my energy right now? Same thing from 1 to 10. How do you feel in energy? Same thing. We do have low vibration energy and we have high vibrational energies. And so identifying where we're at in the moment is really key. And so when you look at the emotion meter, just to give you an example, for me today, I was feeling in terms of pleasantness when I did the exercise, it was around a 4. And then when I tried to identify in terms of my energy level, I was feeling more around a 5. And so when I look at the emotion meter, it was that I am feeling down. And it is true. That was exactly how I was feeling because there's a lot of things happening in the world right now. There's so many uncertainty happening and I was feeling a little bit down, maybe with everything happening around me and me being an empath, I was able to feel that feeling. And so as you could see, because this tool had allowed me to identify or label that emotion, then I can go even deeper and then start journaling. journaling about what is it about feeling down right now that is creating in my body? What can I do in this moment to recognize this emotion and see what is the story behind it? What is about feeling down? If I could snap myself out of it, what could I do? Should I be calling a friend? Should I go and have a hot cocoa or have a hot shower or a bath? What is it that I can do right now in this moment to tend to myself, to be able to witness, recognize this emotion for myself, have compassion for myself also in this moment, and really honor this emotion and what it's trying to tell me? Okay. And so the good news is that this tool, the Mood Meter, also have an app. I just discovered the app when I was creating this video, which is super cool. And it's called the Mood Meter. I will be putting the link in the show notes for this video. And so here we go. If you are able to really use this tool every day, I will highly recommend it, because this will definitely allow you to elevate your vocabulary in terms of clearly and fully describing what is that emotion you are feeling in the moment, because that will at the same time allow you to increase your own emotional responsiveness in terms of what is happening around you and in the world as well. And we need a lot of high emotionally intelligent leaders right now in the world to be able to lead us and be able to support everybody around us and teach them different ways and different tools to be able to express themselves. So here we go. This was my little quick tool to help you navigate this in certain times. And I cannot wait to hear what you think about it. And definitely let me know in the comments. And until the next video, have an amazing day or evening. Ciao, ciao.